Well, internet sensation Bruce the Cat has more than 40,000 Facebook followers, and he is now the star of his very own book, Bruce Finds a Home. A very warm welcome to author and owner of Bruce, Catherine Van Bee.
Yes, welcome.
Welcome. First up, tell us a little bit about the true story of Bruce.
Well, the real Bruce story is that I was walking home from work one day and it was a gloomy, rainy day, and I saw this tiny little thing on the footpath that looked a bit like a mouse or a rat, and I picked it up and it was a newborn kitten. It still had its eyes closed and had its umbilical cord attached, and I knocked on the door and of all the neighbours, and it didn't belong to anyone, so I took him home and reared him from an infant.
And what sort of care does a newborn kitten require? Because that must be round the clock.
It was round the clock, so I had to find some special kitten formula from the pet shop and feed him every few hours, including overnight, and he went through quite a lot of washing as well during that period.
Oh my goodness, and just so tiny. If you'd left him, he would have died.
I'm pretty sure he would have, yeah.
And how did he come to be there, do we know?
My vet at the time thought that his mother was probably a stray who was transporting him from one place to the next and perhaps got startled and dropped him on the ground.
Well, it must have been serendipity, everybody meeting at the same time at the same place, which we really like, because now, you know, it's turned into something quite amazing. How did Bruce get the name Bruce, out of curiosity?
Oh, well, my husband and I were thinking perhaps we'll name him after some kind of famous orphan, and Batman sprang to mind, so he's named after Bruce Wayne.
He
actually changed colour as he got older, he turned black, so it turned out to be extra appropriate.
Absolutely perfect. Your book, Bruce Finds a Home, it's loosely based on your story of finding Bruce, isn't it? So tell me a little bit about this. How did that come about?
Well, Bruce, I started a Facebook page for him when I was first looking after him, and it went viral, which I wasn't expecting. I just started it for family and friends.
Cats on the internet, what did you expect?
Yeah, I should have known better. And then he ended up with this quite big audience, and I thought, oh, I wonder, because I'm a writer, and I thought, oh, maybe I could write something that would suit Bruce's audience. And the more I thought about it, the more I thought a children's book might be the right way to tell his story.
What do you think, Catherine, captivated the world about Bruce? What was it?
Well, at the beginning it was a life and death struggle for survival, because he was quite sick at the beginning for quite a few weeks. So I think people were tuning in and giving their support and just seeing how he was doing, which was actually really nice for me to have all that support. And then there became this new drama and mystery of what kind of cat's he going to be, because when he was really little he looked like he might be a Siamese or a British Blue.
Yes.
He turned out to be a black moggy.
Just a moggy. And that's the thing, isn't it? Because sometimes in the world there's so much going on. You just want to check in with something and see a really feel-good story and follow the progress of something. So the book, you've illustrated it as well. You got help from some children though, didn't you?
I did. So my family and Bruce, we've moved down to Dunedin. We live in Porcharmers now, and which Bruce loves. And we've got a really great local school, Porcharmers School, down there. And I've worked quite closely with the children there, and they helped me with the development of the book. So that's been really nice.
And when you're writing a book like that, what's important when you're writing a book? Is it the pictures or is it the hook? No. Or is it the rhyming? You know, I guess because it's quite hard to put together a book like that. People may think it's easy, but what's the important thing to get right?
Yeah, well, I hadn't done anything like this before, and I guess it did surprise me how long every element of it took. So the writing, it's obviously a very short story, but even that took quite a lot longer than I thought. And then the pictures, that was a big learning curve for me, because I've never done anything quite like this before. But luckily my husband's an art teacher, so I had some support.
You
mentioned that Bruce has got fans, I mean, not just around New Zealand, his fans come from all over the world, don't they?
They do. He's got a lot of fans in the States and in Germany and everywhere you could think of, really.
And does he get presents?
He does. He gets a lot of presents at Christmas time and around his birthday.
So what does he get? What do you send a cat over the other side of the world?
He'll get toys.
Toys, yeah.
Yeah, and food, special cat treats that you can only get in certain parts of the world.
And is there an area of the world that's, you know, stands out as big Bruce fans?
More of his fans live in America than anywhere else, but he tends to get presents from probably people in America, Germany and Holland, I would say, would be the main.
Yeah. Very giving, the Germans and the Hollands.
Yeah.
That's good, I like that. And the transformation from him going to a black cat, Tell us about that. Did you incorporate that into the storyline, you know, and the fans, were they all part of that journey as well?
Yeah, the fans were, because it was very intriguing. So it's not part of this book, but if I ever do a follow-up, that could be a good idea for one, so thanks.
That's all right.
He's a gorgeous-looking cat. Absolutely stunning.
Yeah. He's a handsome little fellow.
And how is he? Because, I mean, cats have different personalities. Is he nice and well-adjusted after his sort of abrupt start into the
world? He's great, because I was worried, because when I was researching how to look after orphaned kittens, quite a few people did say they can grow up to have behavioural issues, but he's just a normal scallywag. He's a bit smaller than your average cat.
Mm. Well, he was what, this big when he started?
Oh, tiny.
Gosh.
So we've got, you know, his fan base on the internet, we've got the book. What is next for Bruce?
Oh, well...
Possibly
another book. We'll see how we go, but this one's been getting good reviews so far, so another book could be in the works.
Excellent. And then a movie, and then global domination for
yes.
Bruce. Bruce
I'd
could play himself
so.
In a movie, couldn't he?
Yeah, maybe a line of onesies.
Yeah. There you go.
Or maybe, yeah, Bruce gets a baby brother or something. Along those lines, you never know. Hey, well, thank you so much for joining us.
Brilliant.
Catherine's book, Bruce Finds a Home, is available in all good bookshops. And to find out more about the star of the story, Bruce, that's the best name, you can check out his website or Facebook page. So many gorgeous photos and videos too.
Yeah, it's one of those books you want to read out loud. It's very, very clever and very cute. Well done. Thank you.